After crimping an uninsulated wire terminal onto a wire, you're going to need to apply heat shrink over the terminal barrel for a bit of additional electrical protection and strain relief. And that's exactly what we're going to be covering here in lesson number 4 of this wire terminals playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Let's get started. Choosing the right heat shrink. Now, my favorite heat shrink, and therefore the heat shrink that we include in all of our kits at shop.explorist.life, is 3-to-1 dual wall heat shrink. But what does that mean? So 3-to-1 just tells us how much the heat shrink is going to shrink when heated. For example, if a piece of 3-to-1 heat shrink were 3 inches in diameter before heating, it could be as small as 1 inch in diameter afterwards. The dual wall feature of our heat shrink is also known as adhesive lined heat shrink. The outer wall is the actual heat shrink part, and the inner wall, if you will, is just a layer or a tube of adhesive that will melt and activate at a temperature that's just slightly less than the shrinking temperature of the outer wall. The glue adds just a tiny bit of strain relief to the connection, but also makes the connection watertight, which may help with corrosion over time. What size of heat shrink is best? For the diameter of the heat shrink, you just want to make it so that the heat shrink will actually fit over the terminal, but isn't so big that it will actually still shrink down enough to seal up the connection. And here's a graph of the 3-to-1 heat shrink sizes that we find the best for various sizes of wire that we include with our kits. How to use heat shrink. Now I have a wire lug crimped onto this terminal, and don't worry, we will be covering how to crimp terminals, but I wanted to cover heat shrink first because all of those upcoming videos are going to use this skill. So using heat shrink is really pretty simple. We just need to put the heat shrink over the terminal and position it so that it covers the gap between the insulation and the lug, which should be pretty minimal here. And we also want to make sure that it's not interfering with the electrical connection on the back or the front of the lug whenever the lug is attached to the component. Turn on our heat gun. And then we can put the heat shrink over the heat gun and turn the wire, and so that the heat shrink shrinks evenly. And we want to keep this rotating so we don't burn the heat shrink. And we're finished with this connection whenever you can see the adhesive coming out of the heat shrink itself. Can I use an open flame for heat shrink? A lot of people like to use an open flame for heat shrink, and an open flame will most definitely shrink the heat shrink and melt the adhesive. But in my experience, it's really easy to burn or split the heat shrink when using an open flame, so be careful. It also leaves some soot on the heat shrink, which, you know, sort of doesn't look very nice. Now, if I'm building one of these systems without access to power, I'll use a battery-powered heat gun rather than an open flame. And it's not quite as powerful as a plug-in to the wall unit, but ultimately, in a pinch, this is going to work better than an open flame if you don't have power. Now, we're going to be putting heat shrink on most of our terminals throughout the rest of this academy, so be sure to bookmark this lesson for future reference and come back to it if you need a refresher, because going forward, I'm just going to assume that you know how to heat shrink a terminal. Now that you know how to heat shrink wires, I'm going to teach you everything that you need to know about crimping wire lugs onto wire. So click up here to watch, and I'll see you over there.